my name is Jordan, welcome to another Oscar review. Today we're going to be taking a look at the MTH RailKing New York Central O-27 Madison Passenger Car Set. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I have the one and only New York Central Madison Passenger Car Set from MTH. Now, on my last video when I did the review on the MTH RailKing New York Central Commodore Vanderbilt, which was the 2017 model, you may have noticed at the end of the video, these four passenger cars are running behind it. Well, about a few weeks after I got the Commodore, I believe it was like a week and a half or 2 weeks after I got the Commodore, I, of course, did not have any matching New York Central passenger cars to go with it. And so what I found myself doing is running the Commodore with my Lionel Lion Chief Polar Express passenger cars. And of course, that looked pretty dumb and very unprototypical because, of course, this is not the Polar Express. This is the Commodore Vanderbilt. So, of course, it didn't look good, but it was somewhat New York Central paint scheme wise, because even though, of course, the colors were completely unmatched, like the dark, like the blue and then the red, I mean, it was not matching. But what was kind of New York Central ish was that I had the stripe in the middle, and that was like the red stripe in the middle, and that was basically like the only thing that would look similar to a New York Central passenger car set. So when I got the Commodore, I had to run the Commodore Vanderbilt with the Polar Express passenger cars, and I had to stick with that for the last few days, or for the next few days I've owned the Commodore. But then I then came to my senses and thought about getting a passenger car set for my Commodore, because of course, what is the point of running a Commodore Vanderbilt, like the famous train that is, and not run matching passenger cars with it? And so that's when I decided I'm gonna go online and see if there's any passenger cars that could go well with the Commodore. And soon enough, I did end up finding some, but of course, this is a common issue that most people find with model railroading, and that of course is with really high prices for what you get. And a lot of course, the prices I was finding was like passenger car sets going from $180 to over $200 for a four car set, even more than that, and or even more passenger cars than that. But it was just very pricey, and I was having some pretty bad luck finding my own passenger cars. But then, as time went on and I continued to search, I finally found a passenger car set that was $180 in my price range, and best of all, it took very, very fast to ship, and that was also the best of all. And I got this passenger car set for a total of $180, and I got it from eBay, and it was a very nice seller. The seller was very, very nice. This passenger car set shipped very quickly, and that was something I was really happy about. And so about 2 weeks after I got my Commodore, I finally got the matching passenger car set, and ever since I've gotten these passenger cars, this set has looked absolutely insane with the Commodore, and it just looks absolutely amazing. Now, with the story out of the line, let's go ahead and talk about these passenger cars. Now, the Madison passenger cars are kind of like a mixture of old school and new school, because, of course, back in the day, like back in the 1920s to the early 30s, of course, the New York Central used the dark green Pullman passenger cars, and those were pretty cool. And that's what was known for the Commodore Vanderbilt running back when it made its first debut as the Commodore Vanderbilt and not 5344. Now, I wish I could have been able to get those Pullman passenger cars, because that would be the most prototypical, but I wasn't able to find those. And I did end up finding them, but they were not for RailKing engines. They were for Premier engines, so it wouldn't look realistic to have super long passenger cars to go with a RailKing engine, because RailKing engines are not scale, and that's of course would have been a problem, and it wouldn't look realistic to have long passenger cars that are much longer than the engine itself, and it just would not look good. So of course I wasn't able to get those, but of course I couldn't necessarily get the streamlined passenger cars either, because of course that would basically be too new for the Commodore, because the Commodore Vanderbilt lasted until like early 1938 or 1939, and when it got restreamlined to look like the Chafis Hudson like, of course, what we all know the 20th Century Limited does. And so I wasn't really able to go for that route either. And so that's when I found these Madison passenger cars, which is basically newer than the Pullman cars, but it was before the streamlined passenger cars came into play. So I'm happy with these passenger cars because it's in the middle. They're not the streamlined passenger cars, and they're still not too new for the Commodore, as it's basically a version of the passenger cars that were before the streamline, but they're like just a bit newer than the old dark green Pullman passenger cars. So I'm happy that I got these because these actually match very well with the Commodore's paint scheme, because I got the dark gray version of the Commodore, which is how the Commodore looked when it was first debuted. It had the dark gray, and then as years went on, and of course the New York Central started to have the Dreyfus Hudsons, then they decided to paint it like a bright, like a light gray, and then eventually it was then restreamlined to the Dreyfus Hudson. So that's basically that's basically the thing that I'm really happy about, is that it does have matching colors to go with the Commodore, which I'm very happy about. The base color is that dark gray that matches very well with the Commodore, which I'm very happy about, and it looks very good when the chain is coming down the rails. All right, so now with all that story stuff out of the way, let's go ahead and talk about the features that are that this these passenger cars come with. So these passenger cars come with die-cast metal trucks, a detailed ABS plastic body, overhead interior illumination. Now these do not have LED lighting because these are older, so they do have fluorescent light bulbs. These do have operating metal couplers, a detailed interior seating, end of car rubber diaphragms, and last but not least, detailed undercarriage. So you're getting a very good deal with these four passenger cars, with all these nice details and a lot of stuff that even though you think that you wouldn't really necessarily get because these are RailKing passenger cars, MTH is still, of course, doing a very nice job, giving you a lot of detail and giving you a lot of features with these passenger cars, even though, of course, this is a mid-level train line, I guess you could say, or product line, I should say. Now, when I got these passenger cars, they all came in their own box. Now, I'm not going to show you guys every single box because every single box looks basically the same except for the labels on the ends. But here's what the box looked like. A typical RailKing packaging with a bright yellow and orange. Of course, you have the RailKing logo up here. And then on the front, of course, tells you the features, die-cast metal trucks, what I just went over. Of course, O-27 Madison passenger cars. And there's those other details. And then up on the bottom, we have another RailKing logo. Apologize for the focus. Then here on the side, this is basically the only differences with all the passenger cars, and that's the little label on the side. So on the label on the side, you would usually get the item number, and then you would get like the name of the car. So this one is for the baggage car, which is that one. And it says, of course, New York Central Madison baggage car. And then, of course, you have the QR code. I believe it's QR. I'm probably wrong. And then, of course, you have the address for MTH, just the licensing and stuff like that. Then, of course, the back also has RailKing. Oh, and I also forgot to mention that this does still have the label on it. So, as you can tell, it says lot of four set, and each car was $60 each. So, all four of these passenger cars were all together, and that's pretty cool. Now, inside, they were all wrapped in this no plastic, and then, of course, they were sitting in this nice no foam box and foam little holder to keep the cars nice and snug during shipping, which is very nice, and it's just a very nice box all in general. Pretty typical for RailKing model, for RailKing trains and passenger cars, with all the RailKing logo and then the bright yellow and orange passenger car or boxes, which do look nice. Now, I tried looking for a date or a year for what year these passenger cars came from, but I wasn't able to find that. If you do know that information, let me know in the comments down below so I can see exactly how old these passenger cars are, because I'm not 100% sure. I know these are not new because they do have fluorescent lighting, and of course, MTH is using LED lighting nowadays, of course, especially for their engines, because of course my Commodore has LED lighting instead of fluorescent lighting. So I'm thinking this is probably from the early 2000s. I'm thinking that's kind of what I'm ranging this at, but I'm not sure yet. But if you do know that information, or if I do end up finding the information, I might post it in the description below, but we'll save that for a different time. So now, for the moment we've all been waiting for, let's go ahead and go and take a closer look at these four passenger cars and show you guys all the detail and these great the greatness that these passenger cars hold for RailKing wise. Now, in this review, for the two passenger cars, the two normal passenger coaches, I probably won't take a lot of time going over all of these because they are basically mostly the same. Just of course, one of them is baggage, one of them is an observation car. So I wouldn't go basically go over every single thing because they do basically all look similar except for the sides and stuff like that. So that's probably some of the things that I will probably do to, of course, save another amount of time and not go over every single detail for each passenger car, because most of them all do look similar. So just keep that in mind. And so, of course, we're going to first start off with the baggage car, the two passenger car, passenger coaches, and then end off with the observation car. And then at the end of the video, I'm going to run the Commodore Vanderbilt with these passenger cars for a few minutes and show you guys close-ups of these beautiful passenger cars getting pulled by the majestic Commodore. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get right into it. All right, so let's go ahead and start off with the baggage car. Now, before we get started, I just want to mention that I did turn on the track power because I thought it was gonna be a lot more better to just turn on the track power so you can see how the interior lighting looks. And of course, you can get a better look at how the interior looks with the lighting instead of having to, of course, like flash a light into the passenger car instead of just turning on the track power. So that's what I went ahead and did. And as you can tell, of course, the track power is on if you look through the windows. So it's going to be a lot more easier for me to do that, so let's go ahead and get started. Alright, so here's a look at the front of the baggage car. As you can see, of course, you have the you have the metal coupler that was, of course, described on the box, which is very nice and solid. Feels very nice to the touch. It has a nice little spring on the bottom to, of course, move around while the train is moving in the curves. Of course, to open up the couplers, of course, have a little lever that you just push down and opens up. And, of course, if you want to close it, close it just like that. Now, I've actually had a pretty cool little thing happen with these passenger cars. So instead of having to like push the passenger cars into the back of the Commodore to get them coupled up, all I had to do is basically reverse the Commodore into the baggage car, and it just coupled right up, and that was pretty cool. So I didn't have to do anything with the passenger cars to get the Commodore coupled up with these passenger cars, which is pretty nice. And that just tells you that these things are pretty heavy duty, and they do couple up very nicely. Making our way up, yeah, as you can see, you have this very nicely done simply applied rubber diaphragm. This is very nicely done. It's heavy duty. It's very sturdy, and it feels nice to the touch. And in between in the diaphragm, you have a molded in door. The door does not open, or I do want to mention that none of the doors open on these passenger cars, but they do still look nice in any way. And of course, there is a plastic insert, and you can see the light shining through that little window, which is pretty cool. On each side of the passenger cars, you have some nice molded in detail. And if I can move this car a little bit, you could see there is a little separately applied brake wheel right here, which does look nice. There is brake wheels on both ends of the passenger cars, which do look nice. Alright, so here's a look at the top of the passenger cars. There's not much to see, but you do have some nice riveting detail going along the back, or along the top. And then you do have these little vents, I think. They could be vents all along the sides. And now there's like three on each side. But with like the passenger cars, there's more of these little molded in details and stuff like that, which does look nice. All right, so here's a look at the other side of the car. Now here's that brake wheel I was talking about. On the other end, the brake wheel was on this side. And then on this side, the brake wheel was on this side. So there you go. You can get a better look at that little brake wheel right there. It does look pretty nice. And if you can get a better look at the door, there is a little molded in door handle in there, and of course there is that plastic insert in there as well. All right, so here's a look at the side of the baggage car. As you can tell, going from the left to right, you have this very nice beautiful dark gray stripe going along the side of the passenger car, and you have this little white little stripe on the top as an overlay. And then if you do look closely here, I don't think you can see on camera, but this is actually like an old lip that's like sticking out on this bottom stripe, which is actually pretty cool. Of course, starting from the back right here, of course you have a nice ribbon detail going along from the back to the top, all the way back to the back. And then you have some nice ribbon detail going along there, 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 and there, and there. And so there's a lot of ribbon detail, and of course along the bottom as well, which looks very nice. Of course, in this middle, you have this very crisp looking New York Central logo, or text, I should say. And then below that, you can see this little row number right here, which is 8986. Of course, for the doors, you have some nice plastic inserts in there. You have some nice little molded in detail right here. Like I said, these do not open, but they still do look nice. And then right here, you have a little separately applied metal grab iron right here. On the other door, it's basically the same, but it's opposite. So instead of the door handle being over here, over there, it's over here. And of course, the grab iron is on the other side as well. All right, so here's a look at one of the trucks. As you can tell, they're very nicely done. You have some very nice little cast-in detail on these trucks. Like I said, these are metal trucks, so they are very nice and nicely done and heavy-duty. And they are durable. As you can tell, of course, these are three-wheel trucks or six-wheel trucks on all passenger cars, and they do look very nice. Of course, they do have metal wheels, of course, and they are very nicely done. Up in the middle of the passenger car, as you can tell, you can see these little, some of the undercarriage detail that was described in the box. You can see like these little hinges right there on these little metal boxes. And then, of course, I think these might be like electrical boxes. I'm not 100% sure, but they do look very nice. You have like these little hinge detail, and then like these little handles on the top as well. Just looks really cool in general. Also, if you're curious on what it looks like inside the baggage car, there's not really much in there because it's a baggage car. It's not supposed to have passenger seating in there. It's made for baggage. So, of course, there's tons of room in there for any baggage. You could open this up and add like little suitcases or stuff like that if you do wish to, because these are very easy to open up. There's like four screws on the bottom, and that's all you need to do to add whatever you want in these passenger cars, like baggage and whatever you want, which could be pretty cool. This is not like a like a U.S. postal car where it has like the shelves for all the mail and stuff like that. This is just a baggage car, which does look nice. Now I'm gonna go ahead and lift this thing up real quick, as careful as possible, so I don't short out the track, so you can get a good look at the bottom. So here's a look at the trucks. As you can tell, of course, these are six-wheel trucks, like I described earlier. As you can tell, you have this nice little pickup roller, and what's pretty cool about these pickup rollers is that it has like this little terminal that this wire connects to, and it's not like soldered on. So it's very nicely done. It is sprung, so it is like that on the truck, on the train, or track, on the track. And as you can tell, it's very nicely done. As you can tell, it has been run multiple times by me and stuff like that. And then here's a look at the bottom. As you can tell, the undercarriage detail is very nicely done. It's it's plastic, but it still looks nice either way. You can get a better look at that, like electrical boxes and other stuff like that. And then of course in the middle, it does say MTH Electric Trains Incorporated. Here's a look at the other truck, which does look identical to the other one, which does look nice. And of course, you have that very nice little pickup roller that is very high quality. And of course, instead of the wires being soldered on, they are connected to the trucks, which is very nicely done. MTH did a really nice job on these passenger cars. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and gently set this back on the track so we can move on to the next passenger car of the set. All right, there we go. All right, so it's now time to move on to the first passenger coach car of the set, which is gonna be a lot to go over. Now, because all of these cars do look very identical with the front, top, the back, and the bottom, I don't really need to, of course, go over that. But of course, the things that matter the most is, of course, the sides, because those, of course, are the differences with all these passenger cars. But of course, with the back, for the front, top, and back, and bottom, it's basically all identical stuff. So that's, of course, something that doesn't really need to be gone over with, because they are basically identical. So for the next couple of cars, that basically we'll be going over just the sides and just move on, so you don't have to, I don't have to waste your time going over front, back, front, top, bottom, and just gonna be a waste of time. So of course, let's just go over the sides, and that's of course the differences with all these passenger cars. All right, so here's a look at the front of the side of the first passenger coach car of the set. As you can see right here, you have this nice little molded in door right here, which does have a little plastic insert in there. If you do look closely, there is a little mold in the door handle right there, and it looks like just like a little latch on there, I think. I'm not 100% sure. And then, of course, on the side of the door, you have this little separately plied metal grab iron right there. Below the door, you do have this little molded in door steps right here, which does look nice. Going along the sides, you do have this nice little gray stripe like I went over earlier. And of course, you do have like this little nice metal lip in the middle, which is pretty cool. Of course, you can tell you have this a bunch of riveting detail all over the place going along the top, the bottom, and the sides, which all do look very nice. Now, up in the middle, of course, you do have that nice little New York Central text on the top, but this car doesn't have a road number. Instead, it does have a name, and the name is Park Trail. Now, here's where it gets more interesting. So, of course, like I said, you have a bunch of in the middle, you have a bunch of plastic inserts for windows. And of course, if you look inside, you have a bunch of little seating in there, which does look very nice. They're like double-sided seating. So if you look closely, it's like you have that cushion right there sticking out, and then you have that backrest, and then you have another cushion facing the opposite direction, which does look nice. And it's a very nice detail, very nice interior. And up in the top, like I said before, there is fluorescent lighting. It's not LEDs. I could potentially convert them into LEDs, but I'm not 100% sure if I want to do that yet, or I'll just stick with the fluorescent light bulbs for now. Now, here's where it gets even more interesting. So if you look right here, there's like this little table right here. And then if I go ahead and move the camera a little bit, sorry if this gets a little shaky. If you look over here, there's like a sink or a toilet in there. Look at that. I think that's like a sink. That's like super cool. That's really cool. That's awesome that MTH added that in. I do apologize for the shakiness. I'm trying to do the best I can to not mess around with the light and with the shaking, but I just thought that was a really cool little detail right there to add like a little sink. I think it's a sink. I don't think it's a toilet. It's like a kitchen area or something like that. But that just looks super cool. That's something that I never had something like that in any of my passenger cars before. So that was something pretty cool that I never seen before. And of course, on the other side, of course, you do have another plastic insert for a window. And then, of course, you have the door right here, which is basically the opposite of the other door that was on the front of the passenger car. All right, so here is the second passenger car of the set. As you can tell, it is basically identical to the first passenger coach we went over. But the only difference is the name. And the name is Weppinger's Falls. I don't know if that's a place or that's a waterfall. It sounds like something that would be a waterfall, and that's pretty cool. So, of course, like the first passenger car, it does not have a road number, but it does have a name, which is the Weppinger Falls. And so, of course, this is completely identical to the first passenger car we went over. The same interior, same lighting, same detail, but of course, the only difference is the name right there. So, of course, I don't need to go everything because everything that's in there is basically identical to the first passenger coach we went over. So I don't need to go over that. So let's go ahead and move on to the last and final passenger car of the set. All right, so it's now time for our last and final passenger car of the set. And that is, of course, the observation car, which is one of my personal favorites of the set. So this does have a different interior. And of course, it does have a different end than the two passenger coaches that we went over. So let's go ahead and go over what we have for the observation car. Starting over the front, you do have the normal door that we, of course, have gone over with the last two passenger cars. Of course, you do have a nice set of windows going along the side with all plastic inserts. The door has plastic inserts, and it does all look very nice. Now, if you look closely in the first window, you can see like there's these two seats in here, and then right beside that seat, there's a little sink in there, which is pretty cool. I've never seen anything like that on a passenger car, or I've seen that on passenger cars, but I haven't seen it on my own passenger cars that I've gotten. So that looks pretty cool. Now, starting with the first couple of sets of chairs in this observation car, it does look identical to the last couple of coaches, but it then comes to a point where it gets even more interesting in the back, which is actually pretty awesome. Alright, so here's a look at the back, and this is where it gets super interesting. So if you look closely back in there, you can see there are three chairs on that side that are kind of in a half circle. and that's because we are at the back of the observation car, and so they can get a good look at the back, which is super cool. So it's exactly the same on the other side as well. So you have like three chairs and like a half circle, which looks super cool. So I just thought that was just super cool to have like that corner seating where you have like the six seats that are in like a half circle to, of course, look out in the back of the observation car, which I just thought that was just super cool. Now in the middle, of course, this also does have a different name instead of a row number, and this one is Mummy River. Now one little addition that, of course, is on the observation car is that you do have these little cool little separately applied marker lights on each side, which is super cool. Now, disappointingly, this does not have a little light to light this thing up separately, like a little light that would only light up this little marker light. Kind of disappointed with that, but you could, of course, add in something there if you did want to do so. But what's nice about the lighting on these passenger cars is that it does light these little marker lights up a little bit. As you can tell, you can see like a little bit of the light is shining through that. It's not super bright, but you could, of course, modify this passenger car to, of course, get a little bit more light to shine through that marker light. But of course, I do like that there is that little marker light added onto the side. I just think that looks super cool. And so we get to the most exciting part of the observation car, and that's, of course, the observation deck, or some would call it the business car. So, as you can tell, on the back, you do have a metal coupler, so of course you could, couple something with the back of the observation car if you choose so. As you can see right here, you do have these little molded in steps right here on both sides, so of course it could be like an old door right here that would open up so people can go in there by that way. And of course, that leads into this nice little plastic railings that looks very nice right here. You could potentially add in like a drum head right here if you do choose so. And if you do look in the back right here, you do have three little windows back here, so of course you can get a good look at the view. There is a door back here, but it is molded in, so you can open it, but it still does look nice. And then going up here, you have this nice little little rigid detail right here that goes along the top, like a overhang, which looks pretty cool. And of course, on the other side, you do have that little, the other marker light. And then, of course, you do have a little simply applied grab iron right here, which does look very nice. It's a very nice observation car. And this is the first observation car that I've ever owned that does have, like, this little, I could say realistic-looking observation car. Because, of course, I do have the Polar Express observation car that does look nice and all. But I think this particularly looks much nicer. So of course you could like add like a drum head right here, like for example if you were doing one for the Commodore, you could like add like the 20th Century Limited drum head for like the old Pullman passenger car like this. And so that's basically it for the observation car. Not much to it, but of course it does look very nice as well. And so that is a look around on the MTH RailKing New York Central O-27 Madison passenger cars. These are really solid passenger cars. They are very nicely done. Even though these are MTH RailKing passenger cars, MTH still wanted a way to make these look very, very nice for the price you pay for them. These are not, of course, Premier line passenger cars, so of course they don't have as much detail as, of course, a Premier passenger cars would have. But these are still very nicely done for the price range of course, RailKing, because RailKing is, of course, the mid-range. The mid-price range product line from MTH that, of course, is a lot more affordable than Premier stuff. So, still very nicely done, even though these are, of course, RailKing and not Premier. So, still a very nicely done job for MTH with these RailKing passenger cars. So, here comes the fun part where we go ahead and start up the Majestic Commodore and run it with the passenger cars. Now what I'm going to go ahead and do is do something pretty cool. So what I'm going to do is basically start up the Commodore, put it in reverse, and back the Commodore into the passenger cars, because the passenger cars are docked up at the station, and I just want to have this cool little realistic look to it, to just have some fun. And that's what, of course, what model railroading is all about, just have fun. And that's what, of course, what I'm going to do here, just have a little fun with like backing up the Commodore into the passenger cars while they're docked at the station, and then the Commodore like pulls the cars out of the station, and of course has its little run with it. So I think that's going to be pretty fun to do. So without further ado, let's go ahead and start up the midgets and Commodore up and run it around the layout for a couple of minutes with the passenger cars. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into it.
Thank you. next stop is Elkhart.
One step. Have a nice day.
Thank you.
Welcome aboard. Ticketed passengers only. Let me help you with your baggage.
Now departing from Buffalo on track 2, train number 26, the 20th Century Limited.
Welcome aboard. Step right this way. One step. All aboard. I see the conductor's checked his watch again. Must be time to go.
Giving us a highball signal.
Let's get down the line.
And so that is my review on the MTH RailKing New York Central Madison O-27 cars. I absolutely love this train car set. It's absolutely amazing. When I got these things and put these things on the rails for the first time, I was blown away because it just completely changed how this train looks. And it just looks absolutely insane. And I'm really happy that I made this purchase of getting these four passenger cars because it really makes a huge difference. When they're running behind the Commodore, then of course running Polar Express passenger cars behind it, which of course makes no sense, but this was definitely a big change, and I'm very happy that I got these passenger cars because I would have missed this opportunity to get these amazing passenger cars that were definitely worth the $180 I paid for these things, because these are just very, very nice passenger cars. Even though these are RailKing, these are still very nice passenger cars that I do highlight. I do really recommend getting because these things do really look very nice. And of course, even though these are not scale, and of course they are not as well made as premier passenger cars, these are still really good passenger cars, especially for someone who's on a budget, who doesn't have, of course, over $100 to go, doesn't have over $100 to get a set of premier passenger cars. But other than that, it's a very, very solid passenger car set. And if you do find one of these and you do have a New York Central train like Commodore or 20, or I don't think it will work well with the 20th Century Limited, but maybe like if you have like the Commodore Vanderbilt, or you have like a Mohawk or a Niagara or any of those types of trains, or even a normal J1 or J3 Hudson, these would work well with those types of trains, because of course New York Central has had, of course, multiple different types of trains. Of course, they've had just like the normal Hudsons and normal J1 Hudsons, normal J3 Hudsons, and of course they've had like the Mohawk and the they've always had like the Mohawk and the Niagaras, of course, just running normal, just unstreamlined normal steam engines and pulling passenger trains, which of course, have been well known for the New York Central. So if you have one of those scenarios where you have, of course, a Niagara, a Mohawk, or just a normal J1 Hudson or J3 Hudson, this would work well with those types of steam engines as well, apart from the Commodore. So any scenario, these would probably work great with them, except for like the Streamline 20th Century Limited or the Empire State Express. Of course, those wouldn't really work well with those because, of course, they have like the special Streamline passenger cars. So these would work well with the normal J1s, J1s, J3s, Mohawks, Niagaras, and of course the Commodores. So any of those scenarios, these would work great with those. And so with that being said, I would, of course, tell you the retail price of these, but it's probably far from when these even were normally retailed. So I don't have a retail price for these because I don't think MTH makes these anymore, because of course these have fluorescent lighting, and of course nowadays MTH is putting out LED lighting for the passage cars, LED lighting for the steam engines. Like, as you can tell, my Commodore has LED lighting for the headlight and the backup light, and so forth. So of course this is a much older passage car set from MTH, but it's still a very solid one. I don't know if I'm gonna convert this to LED lighting. I'm not sure yet, but maybe down the line it would, but we'll see. And so with that being said, thank you guys for joining me for today's review. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you do find one of these on eBay or any other train store that you go to, I highly suggest getting one of these for your Mohawk, Niagara, J1 or J3 Hudson, like the Commodore, or just a normal steam engine from the New York Central. Highly recommend getting one of the sets because it just works well for any situation. So with that being said, thank you guys for joining me, and I'll see you guys in the next video. See you guys next time.